Okay, so we're looking at the top of the lock. Around the back of the lock, we've got a single wire running there. This is the slightly messed up with the plastic wire going to the right hand side, and the left is the double wires. The right hand wire has got the yellow plastic tab. The left hand wire has got the yellow protector there on the connector, and the top is just top's got a red plastic tape on it. This is just for my own records. The top of the lock is opposite this ground off bit at the bottom there. So with the ignition turned to off, I hope that's turning up on camera. We can see that that's an open loop on both sides. I'll now turn it on to accessories. And it's going a bit crazy at the moment, but it usually reads good. Now it's reading bad again, 13.2. I don't know whether that's the gauge or yeah, that's strange. I was getting a perfect reading last time. Just put it into the that should be an open loop. That goes to the engine. This is accessories. Seems to change around a lot. I was getting a good reading on that last time. So we'll put it onto the engine, off the accessories and onto the engine, and I usually get a very good reading from this one. That's perfect. That's the same as putting them together. That's the accessories side. Open loop. It should be an open loop. I'm getting different readings, so I've turned the okay, so I've just reset it. I've turned it to off and on again. Now the key's turned to off with this lock. Open loop. Open loop. That's what it should be. Okay, so it's on accessories. That's the accessories there. So that's a good reading, 0.9, 0.1, or 0.9 or 1. This is an open loop. Okay, so that's perfect. That's a perfect reading. I'll turn it to on again. And it should be from there to there, the ignition. Okay, this time we're getting a good reading. Okay, that should settle right down to 4 zeros. That's a good reading. And this should be an open loop. I know. I say it should be an open loop because that's a strange reading. Okay, so I'll just see if we've got continuity. So there's nothing there, there should be an open loop. I'm getting open loop readings some of the time on here and some of the time not. Just wiggle the key around a bit. That's strange. I'm getting different readings. I don't know whether it's the, the gauge or faulty ignition. So now I've got the key turned on to how it was before. I'm getting the reading this time. It wasn't before. Okay, so there we go. So the key's turned on all the way, and this time I'm not getting any reading there, I'm only getting open loop. So just wiggle the key around a bit. Now I've got a connection between here and here. So you may be able to see what I mean. And sometimes there's absolutely no reading on this here, see? It must be okay. Okay, so this is a wide open circuit. The key's turned on to the ignition and accessories. I'll just do an ohms test again. So we're going for an ohms test. Hopefully my hand's not blocking the screen there. So I'm getting a fairly high reading with the ignition. Oh no, sorry, not the ignition, the accessories, but the ignition is very good. I don't know if that's going to turn up on show up on camera, but that's point one. And accessories is there it is again. Six is counting down. 6.6. 5.7. It seems to be different every time. Counting up, 6.6. 6.3, it's holding it. 6.1, 6.2. No, these are only $30 delivered. I think I'll get myself a new ignition switch, and they'll just rule it out of the equation.